9 male cancer symptoms you should not ignore. Cancer is one of the world's top killers today, and as you may well know, most cancers do not have a cure once they're full-blown. However, being able to diagnose cancer early enough might just save your life. Cancer cells spotted very early can be removed through a number of medical procedures like chemotherapy. The challenge for men, though, is that they usually don't like to see a doctor. For some reason, seeing a doctor for any slightest concern isn't considered manly. But hey, folks, the early visit to the doctor could be the difference between life and death. And yeah, you don't have to see the doctor for every slight health concern, but if you have any of the 9 symptoms we'll be looking at in today's video, then you should definitely see your doctor. Number 9, persistent cough. Now, it's normal to have a bout of cough once in a while. Sometimes it could just be a common cold, a symptom of a flu, or even an allergic reaction to something. The common denominator with all these 3 is that not long afterwards, the cough eventually goes. Oh, and you could also have a cough as a side effect of taking medication. So yeah, not every bout of cough is a cause for concern. However, if you have a prolonged cough, now that's when you should be thinking about visiting the hospital. So what do we mean by a prolonged cough? Let's just say that any bout of cough that lasts beyond 3 to 4 weeks. Now, we aren't saying that this is a definite symptom, but we're saying that this is a symptom you should not ignore. Prolonged cough could be a symptom of cancer, but it could also indicate other medical issues that you may not be aware of. For instance, chronic bronchitis and acid reflux both share prolonged cough as possible symptoms. There are also a host of other possibilities, so diagnosing them early prevents them from getting more serious. If you visit a doctor to complain about a prolonged cough, you can expect the doctor to take a careful medical history and conduct a thorough examination of your throat. The doctor will also check to see how well your lungs are functioning, and this is even more significant if you are a smoker. You should also not rule out the chances of taking an X-ray, as the doctor will leave no stone unturned in trying to find out the root cause of the prolonged cough. Once the cause of the cough is identified, the doctor will sit with you to discuss a treatment plan. Number 8. Finding blood where it shouldn't be. Many things can lead to bleeding. If you engage in contact sports often, you'll be used to getting bruises, cuts, and the occasional bleeding that comes with it. Or in a bitter winter period, it's not out of place to suffer a nosebleed. If you also use a pretty hard toothbrush, don't be surprised when your gum bleeds. For each of these cases, you can clearly explain the cause of bleeding. Now, if you spot bleeding from any part of your body and you cannot explain the reason, that is a definite red flag. Pun intended. If you notice some blood when you cough or spit, you should immediately seek medical help. Then there's the matter of blood in your stool. We know that hemorrhoids are a common cause of bleeding in your stool, but that's not always the case. We don't mean to scare you, but finding blood in your stool could point to colon cancer. The only way you can rule out colon cancer is to see a doctor. The same goes for blood in your urine. When you speak with a doctor, the doctor will certainly want to know some things about your symptoms. So be truthful and open, they're there to help. One of the reasons men may not be too keen on going to see their doctor when they spot blood in their urine or stool, for instance, is that they don't want to be subjected to the dreaded colonoscopy. We understand that placing a long, flexible tube through your anus and into your colon could feel extremely invasive. But it is one of the most effective ways to rule out colon cancer. Besides, a colonoscopy could tell you more about the cause of the bleeding, even if it isn't cancer. Number 7, urinary problems. As men grow older, visiting the urinal becomes less easy. Now, this may not happen to all men, but it sure does happen to a lot of men. Older men tend to have more frequent urges to pee. The challenge is that even with the sense of urgency to pee, they don't feel like they completely empty their bladder when they go number 1. Initially, this may feel like something that can be managed or maybe gotten used to, but sometimes it just gets worse and a lot more uncomfortable. If it does get worse, then you shouldn't think of it as an old man syndrome. You need to see a doctor, because at that point, there could be some serious concern about your prostate. The doctor will conduct what is called a digital rectal exam. The information gotten from the rectal will confirm whether or not the prostate gland is enlarged. Now, prostate gland enlargement is pretty normal as a man gets older, and this usually happens because of a condition called benign prostatic hyperplasia, often shortened to BPH. This is a non-cancerous condition, so if this is the case of the inflammation, then you can worry less. The doctor may also decide to order a blood test. The purpose of the blood test will be to check the level of prostate-specific antigen, or PSA for short. This compound is produced in the prostate gland and is often used as a strong indicator to determine the possibility of prostate cancer. If the PSA is higher than it normally should be, the doctor will then refer you to a urologist or even order a biopsy. This is what will detect the cancer, if there is any. Number 6. Breast mass. Many people assume that breast cancer is peculiar to women, but that's not true. Although it's not common, men can also develop breast cancer. This is why spotting any new mass in the breast area of a man is a sign that should definitely not be ignored. According to the American Cancer Society, there are a number of signs that men and women should look out for in their breasts. These signs could be indicative of cancer, and once any of them is spotted, you should see a doctor right away. These signs include skin dimpling or puckering, nipple retraction, redness or scarring of the nipple or skin of the breast, and nipple discharge. On visiting a doctor, the doctor will take a careful medical history and proceed to carry out a physical examination. If the doctor considers it necessary, they may order a mammogram, a biopsy, or some other test to confirm or rule out the presence of cancerous tissue in the breasts. Number 5. Changes in the lymph nodes. The lymph nodes are an important part of your body's immune system. They contain lymphocytes, which are white blood cells that help to fight against diseases and infections. Lymph nodes are located under your armpit, in your neck, and some other areas of the body. Occasionally, these lymph nodes could swell up and become larger, but after a short while, they return to their normal sizes. However, if you notice that a lymph node only keeps getting larger, and it does so over a long period of time, say over 4 weeks, this is a cause for concern. And yes, you need to see the doctor. Your doctor will conduct a physical examination and try to discover any related issues that could explain the enlargement of the lymph nodes. For instance, an infection could cause the lymph nodes to be enlarged. If the doctor cannot discover any infection, then they will typically order a biopsy. Number 4. Unexplained weight loss. We should all keep our weight in check and stay healthy. And while some may not enjoy it, exercising regularly and eating healthy are two of the key things required to lose weight. And yeah, we agree that it's not always easy to do this, which is why it becomes a matter of concern when you lose weight inexplicably, without even trying. And by losing weight, we don't mean a pound or two. If a man loses up to 10% of his body weight in just a few weeks without putting in any deliberate effort, it's a red flag, and it requires the doctor's attention. The cause of such weight loss can be tricky to tell without running tests, but one cannot rule out cancer. Typically, the doctor will conduct a general physical examination for you and ask you questions related to your diet and your exercise routine. The doctor will also want to find out about any other symptoms you might be experiencing, as this could help narrow down the cause of the weight loss. After gathering the necessary information, the doctor will make a decision on whether further tests might be needed. Number 3. Difficulty with swallowing. Usually, as men grow older, they complain about difficulty in swallowing food. Some men learn to cope with it. Such coping mechanisms could include changing one's diet from a more solid one to a liquid one. That said, swallowing difficulties could be an indicator of a gastrointestinal cancer such as cancer of the esophagus. Having trouble swallowing is a symptom that most men are likely to ignore and explain away, but that may be costly. You should let your doctor know if you're having any trouble swallowing. The doctor will take down a careful medical history and could possibly order an X-ray examination. If required, the doctor could send you to a specialist to examine your esophagus and your upper gastrointestinal tract via an upper endoscopy. Number 2. Changes in the skin. Moles are a well-known sign of potential skin cancer, so if you discover any moles on your skin, you should speak to your doctor about it. But moles are quite an obvious symptom. What might appear less worrisome to men is a change in skin color. Changes in skin pigmentation could be indicative of skin cancer, and that's why it should not be ignored. The same goes with sudden bleeding on your skin. Remember, we have already said that unexplained bleeding should always be met by medical attention. Excessive scaling on the skin is also another reason to seek an appointment with your doctor. The doctor will normally take a careful medical history, perform a physical examination, and possibly recommend a biopsy to rule out cancer. Number 1. Changes in the testicles. Testicular cancer occurs most often in men who are between 20 and 39 years old. Some doctors suggest that men undergo a monthly self-examination of their testicles. If you notice any change in the size of the testicles, whether it's growth or shrinkage, it's a serious cause for concern. Other telltale signs you should look out for include swellings, lumps, or a feeling of heaviness in the scrotum. Early detection is crucial because testicular cancer occurs very quickly, and that's why regular self-examination is important. On visiting a doctor, they would consult a testicular exam and obtain an overall assessment of your health. If they suspect a cancer, then they might recommend an ultrasound examination of your scrotum or even a biopsy. Comment down below your thoughts, give this a like, share with your friends, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button and notification bell to keep you updated for more interesting facts, tips, and ideas from Smartville.